the month of May, we have our regular dose of No History, No Self with Professor Brandon Riley. Let's watch this.
Envisioning the 7,000 plus islands that comprise the Philippines, the celebrated Filipino writer Nick Joaquin once mused that, quote, "The might have beens of Philippine geography are staggering. It could have been less or even non-existent as a separate entity. There could have been no Philippines at all." The labor of the Spanish period was to not only create a geography, but to preserve what had been created, end quote. His point in saying this was that the vagaries of history and Spanish colonialism's eagerness or laxity are what best explain the contemporary geography of our homeland today. Yet there was another place that was once part of the Philippines that we don't have to imagine as something that could have been. One that few remember today, but which has been connected and reconnected to our history at many points, the Mariana Islands. The Mariana Islands were first inhabited by Austronesian peoples called Chamorros. The first Europeans to encounter the archipelago were the Spanish. Following their landfall in 1521, the islands came to serve as a stopping point en route to what would become their biggest colony in Asia, the Philippines. The Spanish originally called the Mariana Islands Islas de los Ladrones, or Island of Thieves, a pejorative name for sure. They did this because Spanish navigator after navigator found that, upon touching down in the islands, the Chamorros would promptly board their ships and proceed to dispossess them of all their goods. This wasn't theft, mind you, not for the Chamorros at least. Rather, it's what we might call collective possession, because goods were not owned individually, but rather by the group. I have come to relish in reading accounts of visiting the Mariana Islands, which often recorded testimonies of navigators saying things like, "And then we passed through the Island of Thieves, which is an appropriate name indeed." These things they said because, as they recorded, the Chamorros would even attempt to extract the nails from the very vessels the Spanish had used to travel to the islands. As the Spanish established colonies in the Western Pacific, they brought the Philippines and the Mariana Islands into a common administrative structure. Until 1898, the Mariana Islands were part of the Spanish Philippines. But in fact, this was not the first time that Chamorros and Filipinos had forged linkages. As we discussed last week, Filipinos and Chamorros were both Austronesian peoples, so seafarers had been bridging the archipelagos long before Magellan ever stumbled upon them. There has existed a lengthy history of connections between Filipinos and Chamorros ever since these times. Filipinos became part of the process of the Spanish evangelization of the Mariana Islands, with the result that both countries are highly Catholic today. During the War for Independence against Spain, Filipino revolutionaries were infamously incarcerated in Guam. Following American colonization of both places in 1898, Filipinos came as workers to the Mariana Islands, and many even stayed, to the point where one quarter of Guamanians traced their descent to the Philippines today. We usually don't think of the Mariana Islands as part of the Philippines, and of course, administratively, they aren't. The islands are instead a territory of the U.S. But given the history between our two archipelagos, maybe we should.
Here on Kababayan Today, kasama naman natin si Mia McLeod for the Real Estate Buzz. We'll be right back. Don't go away. For past shows of Kababayan Today, please go online to www.la18.tv/Kababayan Today. Or you can tweet me at GTONGI.